Republican presidential candidate Ron Paul raised big bucks and some major eyebrows with a very successful one-day internet fundraising drive. Amazing, amazing numbers.
$4.3 million raised online in a 24-hour period.
It means his supporters dropped $4,380,000 in 24 hours. That's $182,500 per hour. $3,042 per second.
It's an amazing sum of money. I don't remember someone doing that out on the campaign trail. What do you make of this?
Well, and the source of the money is to me what's interesting. He got it from 35,000 small, comparatively small contributors. But I wonder if this ability to raise this kind of money in this short a period of time, and the fact that we're sitting here now talking about it for the third or fourth time this afternoon, might be the launching pad that he's been looking for.
I think we have a very good platform that's very appealing to the people who care about what's happening in this country. I think we're also tapping into the sense of frustration that people are feeling. I think it's much more intense than anybody realized, probably more intense than I had expected.
What is the typical Ron Paul supporter?
Well, the typical supporter is non-descriptive because they're different. They're very, very diverse. They come from all ranks and files, all colors, and all parties. We get Democrats and independents and Republicans. And I like to kid, we even get a few anarchists who'll come to our rallies. So it's everybody's coming together that's sick and tired of big government, and they don't trust the major parties and the leadership of either party right now. And but they do not fit one description.
As long as we live beyond our means, we are destined to live beneath our means. And we have lived beyond our means because we are financing a foreign policy that is so extravagant and beyond what we can control, as well as the spending here at home. And we're depending on the creation of money out of thin air, which is nothing more than debasement of the currency. It's counterfeit. And it is a natural, predictable consequence that you're going to have people benefit from it and other people suffer. And those who get to use the money first, like the military, industrial complex, they make a lot of money and they benefit from it.
A study by the Center for Responsive Politics found that you receive more money from military members than any other GOP candidate. And the reason I find that fascinating is because you are the only GOP presidential candidate who is calling for the withdrawal of troops from Iraq immediately.
Yeah, and you know, sometimes unfairly they challenge us because we take a different position. We take the traditional position that you should only go to war under declaration and win them and get out. And I've taken the position of President Bush when he ran in 2000 of a more humble foreign policy and no nation building. So some people say, well, that's weak for the troops, but it really isn't. It's protecting the troops. I want them to come home. And the fact that we get the money from the military more than all the other Republicans put together is a pretty darn good endorsement. And I've been in the military. I've been in 5 years,
right.
So I believe in a strong national defense. It's just that I have a disagreement on the foreign policy.
We have a national ID card on our doorsteps. It's being implemented right now. We have FISA courts. We have warrantless searches. We've lost habeas corpus. We've had secret prisons around the world, and we have torture going on. That's un-American. But you know, just going for increasing presidential powers, as been discussed, is rather disturbing to me. This whole idea that we're supposed to sacrifice liberty for security, we're advised against that. Don't we remember that when you sacrifice liberty for security, you lose both? That's what's happening in this country today.
All of a sudden, the Ron Paul campaign seems like the Ron Paul movement. 1,500 people packed into the War Memorial Auditorium to see Paul speak. The Republican is making waves for his anti-war, limited government position.
This is just a small example of the types of things that are happening really across the country.